International Partners.
Smoove and Turrell.
Für die ganze Vielfalt dieses schönen, reichen Lebens.
Ladies and Gentlemen.
It's Canny O'Clock, it's live and pre-recorded all the way from the most amazing city of Tokyo. It's your main man, Mr. Smoove, and his trusty little sidekick, Mr. John Turrell. This is the Northern Call Experience.
Good evening, everyone.
Well, hello. I've got like a high-pitched thing in the
Yeah, so far as well, so far. Still there, isn't
it's
it?
Still there. Have we both got tintness at the
same
time?
I think we'll have, aye. Anyway, it's gone now.
Oh, it's gone now. It's gone. Yeah, yeah. Ozzy, I rang Ozzy quickly.
Aye.
Oh,
help.
A drummer. Because he's done a PhD on tintness. And he sorted it for us straight away. Well done, Oz.
Well, do you know what he said?
Deal with it.
Not even working, you know what I mean? Nothing's working at it. I'm going to have to get it working, though.
Just don't worry about it, Smoove.
All right, well, you tell the folks where we are.
Welcome to the capital city of Japan. Yes, you guessed it, we are in Tokyo. So don't forget your camera. Why not take a chilled out stroll across the Shibuya crossing, right in the middle of rush hour? Or if you're feeling a tad raunchy, why not get your kicks in Kichikabucho? You naughty little devil, that's the red light district. Tokyo is a city of the future, with robots that check you into the toilets. Sorry, into your hotel. And toilets that give you a good old squirt up the Brunei. But when it comes to sushi, there's no more futuristic than Genki sushi. They literally cut fish with laser beams from their eyeballs. Fashion really lasts a day in Takeshita Street, so you'll probably be in fashion for an hour max. This city really has it all, from skyscrapers to backstreet bars. So come in, order what you fancy, and say cheers to Tokyo, as it's so
Instagrammable! And I've got one thing to say to that.
How is it?
Don't forget your camera!
Sort of worked.
The Northern Call Experience, the greatest show in the world.
Let's get on with the 30-minute mix.
Smoove in the mix.
Some old songs and some new songs and some songs.
This is Crash Water, and you're listening to the Northern Coal Experience, the greatest show in the world.
This morning, looked out to see the sun, but clouds just fill my skies since you said goodbye. There's no pleasures in a day, there's no place in this world I'd rather be. Without your love, I don't know what to do.
Seems like I'm living in vain.
Thank you. La la la. La 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 la.
Yeah, in the mix, 30 minutes, back to back, cheesy dance music.
Hey, wasn't man.
No, in all seriousness, I started this set with a track that's been in my box since 2004 and stayed in my box all that time. I thought I'd spin it, you know, I've never spun it on the show. Paul Murphy and Mark Wolford project called Jazz Room, and there was two from that. They're not actually from this sleeve, I must have lost the original sleeve. And I used to keep both records in there. Anyway, I started it with a thing called Spiritual South. Absolutely fantastic, the Jazz Room. Love that. And the last thing I played was Afro Art, which again is Paul Murphy, and that was in the same sleeve. I don't know what that's called. Gareth, I think. Anyway, after that, was a track that I used to hammer years ago, and I've lost it. It's somewhere in this room, but I couldn't find it, so I ended up going online and buying another copy. And it's so good. Leroy Hangoffer and Pin, and a track called Lynx, original version. Oh no, that was actually the remix, I do believe. Unbelievable.
Get on with it, man.
Toytonics was in the mix there, and that was the phenomenal Hand Clap Band. Thought I'd drop that once more because
why
so
not?
Groovy.
It's a killer tune.
You know who that is, don't you, John?
Toytonics.
No, the incredible Hand Clap Band.
Yeah.
Phenomenal Hand Clap Band.
Phenomenal name.
It's only our mate, isn't it?
Tony the Tiger.
Nah, who's the guy that remixed this recently? Do it.
Raymond.
Yes.
Mang.
Ray Mang, that's it. Also, another track that was playing up slightly there. I've got some issue with a mix and it's certain records it doesn't like. It's been fussy. Without You, I'll play that next week when I get this mixer fixed, and that's East Coast Love Affair. I love that. And something I've been waiting for a while. Apparently it came in the shops and sold out instantly and I missed it. So I'm glad I got a copy of that. Angela Johnson and Inclusion. Very gospel-y, beautiful. Written and produced by Angela Johnson herself. All instruments and vocables recorded by Angela Johnson.
Vocables?
Vocables, yeah.
Oh, wow.
It's a new thing.
Oh, yeah, that Angela Johnson's got it all happening.
Again, it's this week's Groovin', the label. Ron Trent, this one, Jazz It Up. An old track called Jazz Funk Freedom. Featured on the show a few weeks ago. Very good. And that, in the background, this is Nightmares on Wax. And it's just called Original Mix. Now, coming up later on, we've got some great exclusives. I've got something, a jazz fusion band from Newcastle called, what are they called? Gnats. What a great name. And their brand new single has just dropped on Bandcamp called Cack Bop. We're going to play that later on. And we've also got Emma Noble's brand new track. Watch out for that. And we've got Vanderbilt's new song. What a show.
Get in.
But before we do any of that, let's do this.
John, what's in your box? What's in your box today? John, what's in your box? What are you gonna play?
Oh. Do you like your funk raw?
Oh, yeah.
Do you like it recorded?
Baby,
a little bit crappy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now we're talking. Anyway, this is DeRobert in the Half Truths. Brand new album.
Are they not going to like the fact that you just said, do you like it recorded crappy?
No, because it's like Smoove and Terrell's first album.
Retro, you mean?
Yeah, yeah. Done on a
vintage.
Vintage.
Analog laptop.
Let's call it that, yeah.
That's a great name for next album. Analog laptop.
Yeah, brilliant. This track is called 100 Yard Dash. Check out the drums on this, kidda. It's an absolute beaut. Yeah!
can't break free.
Well, I love that.
Why wouldn't?
There's nothing not to like about that at all, is there? We should do reviews, shouldn't we?
No, you know what I love? I love the fact that it just sounds like it's all in one room. Everyone's just in the room, just going
on top of each other.
Aye.
Like a toilet room or something. Now, because we're in Tokyo today, I thought that it would be very apt. In fact, I bought this just specifically for this because I couldn't find my copy. I've definitely lost this record because I've never seen it for years. So I've got a brand new copy, and it's DJ Crush and Maizo. But this is with DJ Shadow and Black Thought. A classic tune.
But the ground always gonna be uphill, man.
I'm sending this one out for Anthony Curtis.
Yin for yang, I walk on a line between ghetto slang and stimulation of the mind. Life is a labyrinth of dollars and cents as I quest for cream. Through the steam so dense from the sense in me a puff, cause the tunnel is tough. Some lick shots with sound, some a bust from the cannon. Experts, original man, I'll examine. I am in fact lacking confusion as to what's real and what's illusion. I come from Philadelphia, your health you never take for granted. It's hot as the equator in a cipher around the planet. Or abnormal, niggas appearing out of portals and demanding your soul. Who control the eight immortals but the number seven in this continual maze? Where nights fight with days, within my mind never wine blaze. And some say I should change my ways, but it's hard to hear the phrase through the havoc and haze. Thoughts dire lyricism never cease to excel. Great is the great lab dweller. The mentals of the roots are beyond any computer. The judge, prosecutor, or the drug distributor. Respect to the ex Lex Luger. My nigga Malik be the intruder. Philip Fifth Dynasty's the future. And DJ Crush is the producer. You're dealing with the ginseng roots. We get your renaissance looser. Remember me, the thought I represent essentially. And mentally, eventually, you mention me as most high. My decibels are most fly. I come to paint your thoughts black. Your crush wears that.
Now can I get a witness to dismiss Christmas from the Memphis? Man, that's bogus, I try to stay focused. You would think it was the 4th of July, cause an Philadelphia round of applause light up the sky. Why don't ask me? Subtle attitude, sometimes nasty. Foul mouth bitches walk around looking trashy. Bimbos talking about where's the endo. Crack heads leaving babies unattended at the window. To see death and rubbers with strikes. Who got three left? I'm trying to make it, cause if I don't, I'll probably take it. Perseverance is a virtue. The person that you think you hurt, it might hurt you. Your celly might chirp you. Perhaps I go to court this time when I'm summoned. But I'm a rebel to the system, so I might not be coming. So if I fail, man, let's get off the bell. It's just more time to write another story to tell. Ill elements, drop intelligence. Black thought, Malik, we fuck other irrelevance. We got strain on the brain from bodies left in the dust. Man, just leave it to us. Luke, man, you aim and I bust. Fuck betrayal, distrust. Over tracks, we lust. We need to crush from Japan, so no more need to discuss.
Absolute classic, DJ Crush.
What a tune.
I think that was made in the late 90s, even early 2000s.
What would you go for, right? Oh, I'm going to go for...
2001.
Nah, I'm going to say 1999.
We'll have to research it later, because there's nothing written on there.
Right, well, let's research it later and see who wins. There's a prize.
Is it the noughties or is it the 90s?
Yeah, there's a prize in it as well.
Is there?
Aye.
What, I get to keep the record?
Yeah. Oh, I get to keep the record?
Bollocks to that. Now, you know I like drums.
Yeah.
And I like percussion.
Yeah.
And that's it.
We basically.
Well, I've got a record that's all it consists of. You'd never think of that when you hear it. But I got this, you know, like I got that bacon record that was warped to bits either way.
Oh,
this,
what a gutter.
Everything that's coming from Australia. Yeah, this one is, and it was warped again. So I put it on the organ. I've managed to get it.
Ah, so middle class.
So it's playable. Yeah, exactly. Well.
Oh, yes. My record is a little bit distorted, so I just put it on the organ and, you know, it really sorted it out straight away. So I went to see Prince Philip, just stuck the record on, and the bloke just danced all night.
Anyway, I put it on the organ and managed to get it to play. So here we go. It's a bit wobbly, but here we go. This is called Pick the Lock by Den of Thieves. Den of Thieves, I will be in touch for another copy. I'm sure it's already sold out, but I bet you've kept one for yourself. What was that?
The North Sea are jumping.
Exactly. Listen to this, though. John said, oh, yeah, man, there's vibes there. No, that's not allowed. I was like, no, vibes are actually classed as percussion.
No, he said percussion, it was just
percussion.
Drums.
And percussion, I said.
Oh, I didn't hear that bit, like.
Ah, you see. Anyway, Den of Thieves, and that's called Pick the Lock. Absolutely love it. Congratulations, fellas. Please send me another copy.
Yeah. And me as well.
Well, I'll give John the warp warning, put it on his wall.
Yeah, I'm not having that.
I'm not having that.
In fact, you can tell it's Australian because it's like a boomerang, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, the cut's coming back at us.
You may as well chuck that back to the lads and get a fresh one back.
Right, it's that time of the month again.
Sandra Slot, what's in your slot today?
What's in your slot, Sandra?
Oh, well, it still makes us laugh. quite apt, really, because we're in Tokyo, and I spotted this as well, but I let Sandra have it because Sandra's... I'm a gentleman, aren't I?
Exactly.
You know
not
what
like,
I mean?
Not like me, I'll be like, nah.
Anyway, Peggy Goo has got a new album out.
Peggy Goo?
Yes, she goes on roller coasters and that. She doesn't realise she's on them. she gets up to loads of things, you know what I mean? She ended up DJing in a club, realised she was really good at it, and then started writing music. Anyway, Peggy Goo... And Oyuk And this track's called Nabby, and it's a thing of beauty, really. That's what I think. Check it out.
Will I like it?
I think you'll like it.
Not a lot!
Happy birthday, my daughter.
So as John said, she's like basically the Japanese version of Shardy, isn't she?
Yeah, totally. She's got a lovely voice. And I love the 80s sound of the production as well. Yeah. It's cool.
Proper mad for it as well.
At the start, it was mad for it. And, then it went shad for it. You know,
Shardy. Shad for it.
Shad for it.
Good selection, Sandra. If anyone's listening for the first time in their life, you never listened to the show, well, good luck continuing with us. But that is every week we
good
do.
Good luck!
Staying with us. Thank you.
Good luck, kid.
Good luck for that. And that is Sandra's slot, which happens every single week. Unfortunately, it's our receptionist who insists on putting her awful musical taste upon us. Well, that was a good one this week,
that
Sandra. Thanks a lot.
Good one, Sandra. Well done.
And she struggles, bless her. She struggles to find one song a week. You know, it's like, you know, she's got nothing else to do.
Because she wants to be hip and happening like us two, but, you know, sadly isn't, you know what I mean? It's one of them, isn't it, really?
Oh, it's exclusive time. And Emma Noble, who I did a remix for quite
Emma,
recently.
Emma.
Gorgeous Emma has done a brand new track with, produced by the guy from Third Degree. So it's obviously going to be good. And it is. It's very fast again. And it's very positive. The song is called We Gonna Live Forever. I don't know whether she's been listening to Fame or something like that.
Well, you know, people remember her name, Emma Noble.
Anyway, she's listening tonight. Hello, Emma. And thanks for sending me this. It's absolutely fantastic. I love it. And here we go. bit of Isley Brothers there at the end, taking off.
Oh, definitely.
Congratulations, Emma, and good luck with the single.
I hope it absolutely does the business.
Well, it brought the sun out, didn't it? We've had the sun for a week now. I think that's our summer over.
Normally being baldy, I'd have a really burnt head. But luckily enough, I've just been putting floors down in that. So
just full of concrete
sun.
on you, like a concrete wig.
It's sort of like the best sunscreen you could ever have is the dirt that's on my skin.
Well, let's give a round of applause for John's hair. No, what's it called? Follicles. Folliculoid. Folliculoid! Anyway, John, what's in your box?
I hadn't cut it since last Friday and it started to go proper tennis ball. And when I was in the shower, I thought, I'll just take a razor to that. Worst mistake ever.
I like what John said today. I obviously got my hair trimmed today. Not that you can see it because I'm up here now. I've obviously grown loads.
I'm over here.
I'm down here now. I've got my hair done today. And I was walking along the fell where we live and John apparently saw us, but I had my headphones and my shades on. And in another world, on volume 45...
I pulled my window down and I was like giving him the V's and, you know, like tell F off and that, you know what I mean? And he just totally didn't notice us and there was a guy behind him properly pissing himself laughing.
I'm glad I missed that.
It was a good one. Like,
how are they? Get on with it. One. What are you going to play this week?
I'm going to play... this is a reissue that's just come back out.
I know what it is.
Piranha and the Peddlers. And this track is called Disco.
I knew you'd play this.
Well, because it's out again on vinyl. Check it
out. Pure John's box.
Come on! The bass.
Whoa, bass.
We like it. Disco is an in thing. We groove with it every day and every night. Did you hear that? Disco. It's still the in thing.
Let's go and groove.
Let's go and groove.
With a disco sound.
With a disco sound.
We like the disco.
Yes, we still like it.
Let's go and groove.
Let's go and groove.
With a disco sound.
With a disco sound.
We like the disco.
Yeah, I still like it. Disco sound, baby. Yeah. We still love it, we still like it. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, baby. Come on, baby.
Nice. All right, then.
Smoove can be very funny sometimes.
Always.
Very funny. Very, very funny.
We can't tell you that. Anyway, I promise you another exclusive. I'm gonna try and get some of these out of the way because the lads are listening, apparently, right now. And thanks to Sean, his father, the bass player's father, for sending me this. Sean Woodward. What a great name.
Woodward.
Woodward. Now the band.
Why has Edward Woodward got
Woodward?
Why has Edward Woodward got five D's in his name?
Because he would.
Because if he didn't, if you can't,
anyway. Anyway, this band are called Gnats, right? And they're from Newcastle, but, you know, we're not playing it because they're from Newcastle. Playing it because it's absolutely amazing. And the guys were asking me, what should we do with the scene? And I was just like, look, do your own thing. Ignore the jazz scene and get on with it. Deal with it.
Exactly.
So anyway, this is an amazing song called Cack Bop. It's available on Bandcamp right now. They recorded this themselves and produced it themselves, and so hats off. Honestly, this is mind-blowing good stuff. Fusion at its best. Absolutely beautiful stuff. That's Cack Bop by Gnats. And the players are King David Icke on drums. Hats off
he's
to
from,
you.
He's from Baker.
He's amazing. And you've got bass, you've got Stan Woodward, who's obviously Sean's son.
He's from Deckham.
And you've got on keys Josh Mitchell. I'm not sure who's doing sax.
Oh, Josh Mitchell, he's from Jesmond, you can tell. He's a Jesmond lad. I tell you what, when the three come together, what a band, man.
I'm looking forward to seeing them live, honestly.
Oh, definitely.
They've got a gig at the Globe, apparently. I'm not sure what the date is, but hit them up on Facebook. Hit them up, just hit them in the face.
Well, if you're from Newcastle, you can always do that, and that's a sign of endearment.
A sign of affection. Yo, I'm on, what are you doing?
Being jars and all that.
We'll be right back. It's finally dropped on 45.
It's the 20th of June for the Globe in Newcastle.
Is it? Are they online now, are they?
Simon is.
Nice one. This is it. This is Take It Easy, and it's sold out before it even got released.
Eee, you little star. Have you got me a copy?
Of course I haven't.
You have, haven't you?
Of course I haven't.
You have, haven't you?
And there you go, that's Recense, a 45 that's sold out, so there's no point even talking about it. It's called Take It Easy, by myself. Astrid Gilberto, her little version, Excursion.
See, when we used to play all over years ago, we used to play this though. So,
I made this nearly 9 years ago.
I was going to say.
And it's only just come out. Obviously, I retweaked it.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Basically,
I've known this for as long as I've known you, really.
Well, it was the highest played track on SoundCloud when we used to use SoundCloud back in the days.
Was it on MySpace, was it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, I still run MySpace records. I haven't sold any copies yet, like.
Oh, aye. That's where I bought mine.
Your space.
Yeah, your space.
Face space. Now, listen, I've been busy remixing, and I've had Neil Harland in the studio with me doing some proper Brit jazz slap funk, and I couldn't help resist. We've just finished it. It's not even
you
mastered.
Couldn't help,
myself. I'm going to have to play it.
Couldn't help resist this.
Going to have to drop it.
Why not?
Well, it's unbelievable. Honestly, Neil, hats off for doing this. And this is King B. And it's obviously coming out on vinyl, but I'm not sure if this is. But here it is. King to the Flower, isn't it? Is that what it's
B
called?
B to the Flower, man.
B to the Flower. I should know
dafty.
That. You daft noob. We'll be right back.
Yeah, I'm over the moon with that leg.
I'm over the moon with King B, man. You know what it is? When Dave left the band and he started King B, like, I sort of, because I love Dave, you know what I mean? I was thinking, oh, what's it going to be like? You know, how's it going to be? And it took ages.
Well,
it took ages.
Dave was the crack, wasn't he?
Yeah.
It's funny as.
It took ages, but now, man, the founder groove, man. It's killer. J.S. Peterson has to play this track.
He has to?
He has to.
He has to.
We're going to make it happen.
We are definitely going to make that happen. Aren't we, Sandra?
Yes.
John, what you got in your box?
Oh, yeah. You know what I've got? I think three of our favourite of all time people on one track.
Sorry, best bit. Go on.
Oh, yeah, the best bit. Best bit, the end. Me bother.
Three of our favourite artists on one track. Who could that be?
Right.
Big Daddy Kane?
Nah. Edan.
Oh, is this Your Old Droog?
Your Old Droog. And?
MF Doom.
MF Doom, right?
Yes. I've ordered the 7-inch of this.
Ah, oh,
it's amazing,
man.
Balls.
This is called Dropout Boogie. Check it out, my man.
My man.
So sad. Don't want to miss that, blood. Go on and get that hockey education. You might be big someday. President.
Fuck school. Go to school, dropped out when I heard that. Too busy trying to figure out where the birds at. And them broads all stop when I hop it. They try to throw me in detention and spop it. But I prospered unlike they intended. Now I'm suspended, I was getting suspended. Posted up outside of my street clothes. Principals tried to keep me out the hall like Pete Rose. Gambling, pop them all with a 6. Four bogeys and more legs, alcoholics. Yesterday, E&J brought rum out today. Tapping bottles like warriors, come out to play. These meddling kids was peddling meds. We sold at high grade like nerds. I paid to solve a square root for me. That's why I broke the goon in a square room for me. But if I went back in time, I would dare be that geek sitting in front of the class doing his homework. Prepping to be somebody in life. Instead of roaming the streets with my mom's kitchen knife. She didn't even rhyme when I told it. Like we bought the whole set from IKEA, I know you stole it. Snuck around real cowardly. Took a metro to go uptown to cop Sour D. Never chill downtown on Bowery. Was either my hood, Flatbush, Harlem, or the Bronx. Out of my mind, straight lunacy. Avoiding truancy and chasing new pussy. You see where that took me. All those years and now I'm paying bookies and playing hooky. Never danced at the prom. I did the dropout boogie.
I don't want to listen. I don't believe in this school system. And let me tell you, I'm 20 years old and I know a lot. Understand? For my age, I know a lot. And where did I learn it? In the streets. Because the school couldn't do nothing for me.
Stick with it, baby. Someday you might be king.
Remain true to the task. Got bad grades, still stay doing the math. Prom night, pack of bones in a flash. Chop a room, out of cone. Let him in with a mask. Envisioning, cocking a hammer and letting it blast. Feasible then with cameras ain't getting the pass. And that's trash. Deserve worse for late night meddling. Bill and I rate still be quite the gentleman. The offbeats, two left hooks, two pork beats. No one powdered sugar, saying New York sweet. Until they blindsided high speed on a cross street. Or swipe a metro car down their face to a raw meat. Remember classmates, some of them bad apes. Hallway jokes to bathroom gag rapes. Property to face, ass bet, dice games for mad papes. Window shatter, just blame the brown dew when the glass breaks. And thank the public school system for providing new landscapes. Deficit in attention, honorable mention for detention. Actions, foul language, words that unleash tensions. Often probably resulted in suspension. As they say, another vacay may lay a yoke teacher up on payday. Or roll a reefer, say hey, and go get the Latigas and the leaves off layaway. Stepped off the bounce, couldn't deal on a day to day. Drop out, boogie, repeat the steps or pave the way, okay? Yo, no say, shalom, instructor chose to stay at home today. His favorite class got along with the two kids. It's still cool up till now, is you stupid? It's all about commerce, regardless who bombed first. More like who stayed calm when the drama bursts.
We'll be right back.
for a tour with Muhammad, my man. Going each and every place with the mic in their hand. SC, Maryland, New Orleans, Motown. We on a war tour with Muhammad, my man. Going each and every place with the mic in their hand. Chinatown, Spokane, London, Tokyo. We on a war tour with Muhammad, face with the mic in their hand. Houston, Delaware, DC, Dallas. We on a war tour with Muhammad, my man. Going each and every place with the mic in their hand. New York, NJ, NC, VA.
People give you air, so I be sublime. It's enjoyable to know you and the concubines. Niggas, take off your coats, ladies act like gems. Sit down, Indian styles, we recite these hymns. See, lyrically, I'm Mario Andretti on the Momo. Ludicrously speedy or infectious with the slow-mo. Heard me in the 80s, JB's on the promo. Am I never in the quest to get the paper on the caper? But now, let me take it to the queen side. I'm taking it to Brooklyn side. All the residential clusters who invade the air. Hold up a second, son, cause we almost there. You could be a black man and lose all your soul. You could be white and blue, but don't prep the road. See, my shit is universal. If you got knowledge of Dolo, I'm down for self. See, there's no one else who could drop it on the angle. They're cute at that. So do that, do that, do that, 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 that. Come on. Do that, do that, do that, 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 that. Do that, do that, do that, that, that. I'm bugging out, but let me get back cause I'm wetting niggas. So run and tell the others cause we are the brothers. I learned how to build mics in my workshop class. So give me the sword and let's not make it the last.
We on a war tour with Muhammad, my man. Going each and every place with the mic in their hand. Chinatown, Spokane, London, Tokyo. We on a war tour with Muhammad, my man. Going each and every place with the mic in their hand. Houston, Delaware, DC, Dallas.
In 89, I simply slid into place. Buddy, 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 all up in your face. A lot of kids was busting rhymes, but they had no taste. Some said Quest was whack, but now is that the case? I have a quest to have a mic in my hand. Without that, it's like Kryptonite and Superman. So shall he come in with the sugar cuts? Wiped off my name, but on stage call me Dynamite. When was the last time you heard the Viper sloppy? Lyrics anonymous, you never hear me copy. Top notch, baby, never coming less. Sky's the limit, you got to believe up in Quest. Sit back, relax, get up off the path. If not that, here's a dance floor, come move that ass. Non-believers, you can check the stats. I wrote with Shaheed and the brother Abstract. Niggas know the time when Quest is in the jam. I never let a statue tell me how nice I am. Coming with more hits than the Braves and the Yankees. Living mad fat like a oversized Bambi. The wackest tools try to diss, it makes me laugh. When my track record's longer than a DC-20 aircraft. So next time that you think you want something here, make something different, take that garbage to say else.
We on a war tour with Muhammad.
Hats off to Nick Bike, who's also just dropped a couple of 45s on Resense label this week, and also this one on Black Buffalo.
With Muhammad, my man.
I don't know if there's any copy of this left, but wow.
Yeah, London, Tokyo.
How beautiful.
So nice.
I mean, Al Green to start off with, but yeah, then just to have that flow on top. This is just creamy, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's just creamy.
Now, what we got? Hang on, let's pick this up and have a little chat here. I played this a few weeks ago and I played it again. This is the Mukatsuku. Thanks to Nick Weston for sending me this. Absolutely
sounds
love it.
Sounds kind of Japanese as
exactly.
Well, doesn't it?
Exactly.
Because of Tokyo and that. Tune.
But I'm going to talk over it because
you know the
I know it as well.
It's moving to
Wasted
it.
Man.
Wasted Man.
Yeah. So some guys, I think
don't
these
let me be they don't walk. You know what I'm saying, Smoove.
You don't know the lyrics, do you? Don't let me be the walking.
Don't let me be the wasted man. I found it out. Thinking, oh, it's
Gina.
No, don't bring it back. Because I don't know the words.
Just freestyle.
Don't let me be the wasted man. 17 left down red eye. Walking man, where the gas is gone. I think that's all that in the
mind. Solo. Anyway, it's a great tune.
Aye. Anyway, that just reminded us of that, so.
Well, I was going to tell you this. That's why I put this on.
So
these beautiful guys from, you know, the Workhouse Sessions guys.
Is that next to the boiler room?
No. These guys, I'm convinced they're from down Middlesbrough, Darlington way. You know,
Kushti Kid has them.
Yeah, and I think they run a shop called Fears. I think that's what it's called, like a DJ shop thing. Anyway, I might be wrong, but anyway, he got in touch and he sent me this beautiful thing. Now, look at that, John.
Oh, that is incredible.
You can't see it, but look.
No, I want to touch it.
You can touch it when I open it. Watch this.
That's scary. Do you know the narcissist in Smoove?
I was thinking, what am I going to do with it? I'm going to have to give it a shot.
For all you listeners who can't see what we're talking about is that there's a thing, and when you open it up, Smoove's face is on it with like a pair of glasses. So the narcissist in Smoove wants to talk about it.
Because they've made that nice artwork. But I was thinking, I'm not going to hang it in my house. I'll just give it to John to put in his bedroom above the bed, so I'm constantly looking at you.
Yeah, you can put that in your own bedroom. So when you're making sweet, beautiful love to your wife, you can look at yourself, you narcissistic bastard.
I'm switching it up right now. Thanks, guys. Thanks for sending that. Appreciate that. Still not sure what I'm going to do. I know what I'll do. I'll give it to Floyd.
See it.
Now then, we've got a few shows booked and we've had a few shows cancelled again because of COVID restrictions. Speaking about our gig at The Point in Sunderland, that's been postponed till God knows when, but it will come. It will happen. So therefore, I think our next gig in the North East, that is, will be the Clooney, which has actually sold out ages ago. And our show at the Hoochie Coochie has also sold out in October. I am thinking of putting another show on just so you can actually come and see us. Well, let's see what happens. Now, exclusive time. The lads have just dropped this today. Well, it's not really exclusive because people have heard it, but not on the airwaves. These guys have supported us on many a gigs. The Vanderbilt Boys.
They're not just a support act, though.
Oh, no.
They're a killer act in themselves, though. You know, Lee? Sometimes when you watch a band who's on before you and you just think, ah, oh, shit. That's how good they are. Like, each of them individually are amazing musicians. I love his voice. I love the keyboards, the drums, you know, they're just a killer outfit.
Well, they've had some time away. They've been working on studio stuff with a lot of other people, like helping them out and doing live broadcasts, as in with us as well. So hats off, guys. But they've got a brand new album underway, and it's unbelievable. This is the single that's coming out first. It's called The House That Vander Built. Perfect. Here we go.
Perfect.
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 And I feel like I am home, and I feel like I belong. You don't know what you mean to me.
Criminal that these are not signed yet. It's absolutely terrible.
It's insane.
It's amazing, this song, boys.
And honestly, as a musician myself, I look at how talented they are as well. You know, like, and this is a musician talking. It's not, you know, your average punter from Sunderland going, yeah, Jordan's proper mint on that keyboard, Lee. No, they're amazing. You know what I'm saying, though?
I do. It's of course crazy. I do.
The whole band, man. Dan on the guitar, forgot to mention him
before.
Yeah,
you did.
What a knob I am, you know what I mean? How much I love them, though. You know, they're a proper band. And they do their own thing as well, you know.
I'll tell you what was funny, though, was Jordan's lockdown videos where he was just playing music himself and looping
with
himself.
With the cat.
Amazing. Oh, amazingly just funky as well. Anyway, moving on, John, what's in your box? We're running out of time.
Oh, well, this is MoMA Ready. And this is We Love Music, original mix, in brackets.
Original.
Check out MoMA. Have I done something wrong? Have I done something right? Yeah, it's definitely playing.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's me, sorry.
Yeah, I'm going to go back. I'm just going to go back. Take it back to the beginning. MC never comes in.
This is just a start. There's something special. We'll be right back.
explain. But do you feel it?
Well, we're going to switch things right up now.
What are you trying to say? Like, my deep, dark loveliness isn't lovely enough for you.
Well, I'm going to take a downtime. I'm going to take you in the back room. That's what I'm going to do.
And my favourite place in any club is the back room. Through. I remember Fabric, right? You know, like, it was kind of weird, Fabric, because you had, like, the back room, which was where the Scratch Perverts and all that played.
Yeah, yeah. And
then
Crash.
And Crash Slaughter. Then you had the... Hurry up.
This is Crash
Slaughter.
No. Right, and then you had the front room, which I never went in because it was full of dialums, and the music was proper cack, right?
Cack, 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 cack.
But in the middle, there was this weird kind of corridor with beds in it.
I feel all right.
But it had a DJ, right? And it, like,
people, in bed.
No, people would just say, lounging all over, where he played some of the best ever music I've ever heard. And that's why, you know, I loved the back room, but I loved the middle room the best. Because I was always off me nuts.
I could never find the middle room, me, like. I say, like, is that not the toilet or something?
With Fabric, can I just tell you, this is a quick story, right? Oh, me and Pagey had went in. And,
if Pagey's involved, it's danger.
It's very dangerous. And we'd done whatever we had done, you know what I mean? We both fell asleep in the middle room. And we woke up when it was about, I don't know, 4 or 5 in the morning. And the club was still going till 7 in the morning. And we suddenly become altruistic, you know what I mean? So Pagey had like a jug of water and he was going round like pouring into people's glasses and all that. And then all of a sudden all the water was gone. And it was just like a massive jug full of ice. And we designed this new dance called Slippy Dancing, where we just poured the ice on the floor and just slipped all over. And there was a massive big circle around it too. We were doing it, right? And when we had finished, it's about, what, 7 o'clock in the morning, the club's shutting.
Waiting.
And we got the bouncer came up and he went, nah, you just need to stay behind. And we thought, oh, no, we're going to get properly done here, like, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Policing the rest of it. And the owner of Fabric came and gave us 2 envelopes, right? An envelope each. And he went, that's for yous. And it was lifetime membership of Fabric, right? Forever, I never have to pay to get in, right? And on my birthday, which is New Year's Eve, I get a bottle of champagne.
What a bonus!
Bonus! Bonus! The story wasn't even that long. You didn't need the goggles, like.
Deep inside, I know that I see no use in running. I can't seem to fall asleep.
I'll say actually.
I'm still alive against my better judgment. I see the.
Anyway. No, so. There you go, so.
There you go, so.
It's time for beautiful music. Not that that wasn't. This is incredible. I spent a fortune trying to get this into the country. It's been round the world 3 times. Took me 2 months to get it. And then I paid a fortune for it. And then eventually I got the income tax bill, you know, like import tax bill. And with surcharges on top, I was devastated. Anyway, it's finally arrived and here it is.
I absolutely adore this album. It's Days and Echoes by Mishka Panpilov.
I don't care how much it costs for import duties.
It's worth it.
I don't care how much it costs, you know, the original price of the record. Just listening to that one song is worth it all. And the fact that you'd spent a fortune made it a little bit sweeter for me.
The whole album's like this. There's only three songs each side, but they're epically long.
Lazy.
Lazy bars. Anyway, so that's Misha doing most of the stuff, and there's a load of other musicians on there. And also, it's on.
Is Grigori the Donkin on there?
Unfortunately, not. It's
one of my favourites, isn't it?
It's on Funk Night Records. Now, their logo, right, is as I like to call it, it's Fnr.
Fnr.
Does it look? Have you seen the. Remember that logo?
Oh, of course.
Fnr. It's like Divid.
Divid.
You like Divid?
I like Divid. You like Mammoth? I like Mammoth.
Funk Night Records. Yeah, so if you want to buy that and get charged an absolute arm and a leg, and another leg.
Yeah, yeah.
When it arrives.
And then
good luck.
Let it get stuck in Brexit for a bit, you know what I mean? It's up to you, but it's worth it.
Now, on a similar tip, John, before you
it's
play this.
It's not a similar tip. It's
just a mellow tip.
Beautiful.
Sorry, yeah. Beautiful,
you know what I mean?
Tip. So anyway, tell the story about the shop.
So like every Friday I go to Stevie Barrett's on the Fell. It's a great shop. It has everything, you know, like it's one of them small shops that, you know, like even if you're thinking I need something to curl me tash, it'll have it, you know what I mean? It's just, you know, Stevie is on point. So like the day I went in, and they're so used to us coming in on a Friday.
Hey, hello.
Hi, Helen. You all right, pet?
Hey, it's lovely to see you again. The sun comes out when you come in.
Well, it's Friday night, Helen, so I'm here. I'm just going to go and get me beer.
Oh, I've got it out here for you, especially with your name on.
Oh, I'm not having Estrella tonight, like.
What? What, you're not having Estrella for, like?
Because I'm in Tokyo.
How can you be in Australia? What? Eh? How's that gone?
Australia.
Sorry, Tokyo?
Well, because I do a radio show, Helen.
A radio show? What?
We just come from somewhere random every week.
I don't know what you mean. Like, you're coming here with your Superbok and your Estrella, and now you want a shanty, as I call it, because I like calling it that. Like, but why are you messing with me head?
I'm not really, it's just I'm a free human and I can buy whatever beer I want. And this week I'm buying that beer. You know what it is, pet? I didn't even think about it. Just let us get me beer and let us get out of here.
Ta-ra!
See you later.
Yeah, I'm really worried about him, like.
That actually happened tonight, though.
You've changed!
But they were a lot cannier than Smoove, like. I love them lasses in the shop, they're brilliant.
Did they speak that high, though?
Helen's got quite a high voice, actually, so... Yeah.
Hell on earth.
No, she's lush, Helen.
Helen back.
I'll not have a bad word said about anyone at Stevie Barrett's.
Stevie Barrett. No, it's not called Stevie Barrett's.
It's the Nissa, but it's still Stevie Barrett.
Stevie Nissa Barrett.
Yeah, yeah. Anyway, this is by Kotz. The album's called Disturbing Body, and this is called Flowers. And honestly, it's a beautiful tune.
How are you going to talk to you anyway?
I hope it's the right one.
Turn it up, man.
Flowers on the body dead, flowers I sent, powder on the eyes of them, they're too young to die. Dying makes a sort of paste, it's good for the eyes. Dying makes a sort of cloud, it broadens the sky. The night skies.
That is rather beautiful, isn't it?
Stunning. It's like
John Martin.
John Martin, Nick Drake. It's got everything.
Everything John needs, really.
Really, yeah. I'm a singer-songwriter by heart, so you know, when I hear something as beautiful as that, I'm dying to hear the whole album. And I'll tell everyone again, it's by Cots. C-O-T-S. Disturbing Body is the album, and I can't wait to hear the whole thing.
Well... Andy Champion used to be in our band many years ago, toured all over the world with us.
I don't think it was many years ago, it was like 3 years ago.
Well, that is quite a few years.
Well, it's not many though.
In
if
my
you're
life.
Talking about many, you're talking about
I was in my 40s then.
It's many years ago.
Yeah,
then.
Exactly. He's now got a new album out and a new outfit.
And it's won loads of awards, you know. This thing is like, you know, like in the jazz world.
Yeah, yeah. Highly acclaimed. This is...
And 2 seconds.
What?
Come on, who's singing on it?
Well, that's what I'm going to say. This is an outfit called Living in Shadows. The album's called Living in Shadows, and the act is called Living in Shadows, and it's Andy Champion and his wife and a few other people.
Zoe Gilby, what a voice, man.
What a voice. But instead of doing the jazz thing that they're renowned for, they've gone more for like what they call pop jazz. Something else.
That's whatever what they call
something
it.
Else.
That's what they call it. I bumped into Andy the other day and I went, what are you up to? He went,
something
pop,
else.
Jazz, something else.
Deal with it. Anyway, here it is. This is an absolutely beautiful song. He started this literally 4 years ago, this song. And
I remember.
This is called For the Dead. It's unbelievable, this song.
Beautiful.
Frame in the sky, a seasonal shift.
Beautiful stuff, that's Living in Shadows.
It's so good I've had to put Wayne the Clock back for at least another 20 seconds. Wait till you watch his move here. I'm going to be fast as a dog.
It's nearly 1 o'clock, as John said. A version excursion, and it's Boris Gardner. See if you can guess what it is. Everyone knows Boris Gardner for doing his gardening, right?
He's probably the best, bar Charlie Dimmock or Alan Titmarsh. Or even that other guy with the curly hair, Monty Don. He's probably the best.
Well, apparently Alan Titmarsh lost the marsh.
What a tit. You set him up, I'll knock him out, Smoove.
All right, John, what you got ready?
Got loads ready, me, like. I can find things, no probs, me, like. As long as I just keep talking and then
drafting away.
Drafting, you know, like.
And I'll do this.
And then probably gonna go on. I like that eye. I like it, Yeah, keep going. Keep doing that.
Keep going.
Keep going. That eye.
Does that help?
Aye, that's great, that like. Right, I found it anyway.
Excellent timing.
I'm a big fan of the super furry animals. I love
hairy furry mammals.
Gruff Rich's lyrics. I love his voice. You know what I mean. And he's just on a track with Boom Bip, and this is called "The Do's and the Don'ts," and it's just lovely.
And do.
Check it out.
Turn it up, my man.
No, I'm already turned up. I think you turned me down the last one.
No.
It was too raj for you.
Thou shall not buy a new mixer.
Thou shall buy a new mixer.
Thou shall. Spending this one out for Toby Kift, because he's a beautiful person and he loves this band.
That's canny. That, as long as that's the two reasons that you're playing it, then I'm with you every step of the way.
Masquerader's ball. Can you see through his disguise? Is he a friend of yours?
The self-titled Incognito, Incognito. And the remix, that, by the way. Does anyone know who they are? No? No? Never heard of them?
Never heard of them, me, like. Someone was talking about them, and they didn't know what they looked like.
Do we know who they are, like?
Didn't know what they looked like. They didn't know what they sounded like.
Do we know who they are?
Do didn't even know who they were, and I was like, ah, who are they? Like, they went incognito.
Well, apparently, all the members in the band don't even know they're in the band.
Well, that's a fact, that. Like, that's a factoid.
It's a factoid. Factoid!
Yay! All the members in incognito don't know each other. Apart from Bluey, because he's like the guy that keeps it together.
Keeps it blue. Right, okay. Here's a fantastic song from the Average White Band. Charity bin find when I was a young kid. What an amazing find.
What a charity box find that is, man.
What an amazing band.
Just saying, how big a balls do you have to have, right, to know that you're so good of a musician that you call yourselves just the Average White Band?
From you know Scotland. I
mean? From Scotland. And they do stuff like that. You know. Just a crazy band.
It's insane to say this, but I'm trying to think, is this politically correct, right? That basically they are the funkiest thing to ever come out of the United Kingdom.
Of
Scotland. No, definitely Scotland. But I mean the United Kingdom.
How are you, man?
Think about their prolific
what
a album.
Blue?
No, think about their albums. Yeah. How much stuff they did, you know what I mean? It's like, it's massive what they did.
I think that. I know, but then you've got to look at Si Mandy and all the rest of it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but they fucked off to America, didn't they? They were like, I'm out of here. I stole something, like, I know something.
Nah, there's so many good British black funk and white funk. And to be honest, does it really matter as long as it's funk?
Doesn't really matter.
Doesn't really matter, does it? Doesn't really matter.
It all remains the same.
Doesn't really matter, does it? Doesn't really matter.
So, John, you're going to take a punt this time, aren't you? Tell the listeners what's happening here.
Well, when I look at my box, right, I know that I've, you know, like, and at the minute,
box.
My box is crap, right, because I'm working so hard on the house that I've really forgotten it, and I listen to audiobooks.
That's living all right.
That's living all right. When you're down with the boys and you're making some noise, that's living all right.
That's living all right.
Who working all day for a packet of pay, and then you send a little home to the wife.
That's right.
And then you kiss the dames, but you don't know the names. That's living all right.
Sorry, Jimmy.
Well, anyway. So, what I'm saying is, right, that I've been a little bit lax with my box because I've had so much else going on in my life that really I couldn't give a fuck. So anyway, I don't.
Working all day for a pay, and they're sitting around in a wife. I love that bit when it goes up, though.
Yeah, yeah, definitely key change, right? So what you're gonna have to tell us is this shite or is it good? But I thought it must have been good because it's in my box, and this is by.
We're gonna find out, aren't we?
Bapiana's Brasilia's 3.
Well, that sounds
good already. By Bapiana, the track is called Sadera. Max it. Are you ready?
Do it.
Fucking dean it.
Fucking dean it. Nah, I don't like it. I love it. It's the best thing you've played all night.
Switch up the sound.
You know this is getting played next week in the show.
Oh, totally.
Definitely the best thing you've played all night.
Ah, oh, it's killer, isn't it? Brazilian knees killers.
What, shaven havens?
No, just tiny trunks.
Massive thumps.
Yeah, check it out, man.
John, I mean, tell me about the release.
Ah, oh, it's a bit gutting, like, because it's playing, I can't check, because it's off Bandcamp.
I see.
So like,
said the blind man to his deaf wife.
Well, there's only one question that we can ask, really, isn't it?
It's as simple as this. Hang on a minute, let's just knock this up.
Only one question we can ask, like, really.
There is, and it goes like this.
When's it coming out on vinyl? When's it coming out on vinyl? When's it coming out on vinyl?
Ha ha ha!
fitted perfect with a tune as well.
Because we did it in time, that's why.
Yeah, of course we did, because the tune was playing.
So when is it coming out of my lake?
As soon as I get off this conversation.
When's it coming out on my lake?
Then I can tell you.
Tuesday, apparently.
Thursday week.
Jalemba the 59th.
October the 39th.
When's it coming out on vinyl?
Brilliant.
We have a laugh, don't we? Now, did you know that Shalimar made some P-Funk once that I've only just discovered in
when's
the last...
When's it coming out on vinyl?
It's already out. Shut up, man.
Just lay it back. You know, everybody's got a fantasy. I got a thing, you got a thing. You know what I'm talking about? But let me tell you about my thing. I've always had this fantasy about going to the planet of Venus and visit Venus, queen of love, and swim with her in the famous river of love. So one night while I was asleep, I must have been dreaming because I heard a voice that said,
you
have been elected to take a trip afar to go galactic. Your destination, the Venus queen of love, your space connection. Is this really paradise I'm in? And are you really standing here next to me? And does your river flow with love? So deep, girl, will you take a swim with me? Take me, take me to the river, baby. 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 Take me to the river, yeah. Baby, why don't you come? Why don't you come with me? Let me be your mighty macho man. Hey, baby bubble, shake it, shake your booty, baby. I really suck it. I really suck it to you, mama. I know you love me. I know you really love me, baby. You know, by this time, she didn't quite understand my language. Coming from a distant place, you know, all this slang I used. But I know she understood where I was coming from, and I know she dug it. Cause when I smiled at her, she smiled at me. And you know, being the gentleman that I am and everything, I didn't want to just take advantage of the lady. I sat there, I talked to her, and I asked her, I said,
is it wrong to touch your pretty hair?
It is quite wrong, actually. Get your hands off.
What have I done? I'm putting my phone down.
No, what he's saying is it touched? Is it wrong to touch your hair?
To
depends
be honest,
what hair.
Well, I'm baldy, so it must be my balls
under your armpits.
Oh no, I've got 12-year-old's armpit hair, mate. Like always have done. I've got no body hair really, apart from my balls in my beard.
Right, moving on from that. You know, like Sal Soul Records made loads of great records and loads of crap records. Well, I've just found a record that's great but also crap at the same time because the lyrical content is really bad. So, I'm going to play it anyway. Right? So, the guy's singing about, I don't think he realises, maybe the translation doesn't work in the UK, but humming, what does humming mean?
Humming or humming?
Humming.
Like,
minging. Stinking.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, rank, yeah.
you know,
I
like,
thought you were thinking something sexy. Because
No. It's the opposite.
I was thinking
opposite.
Something sexy. Opposite. But I didn't want to get the lady listeners getting all worked up about what I was thinking.
Well, the lady listeners. There's only three of them.
No, that's what I'm saying, though. You know, them three probably be off the nuts.
It's all,
you know,
full of blokes, mean? This chat room.
Yeah, man. No, but you didn't know what homing is until you go,
Do it, go on.
You got to be in the left spot.
Boom, boom, boom.
Amen.
Stinking of cabbage.
Amen.
Smelling of cabbage. Oh, amen.
Hey, I just know how to please a lady by humming. Amen.
Are you still humming, John?
Well, I like to, you know, make sure my ladies are happy.
Right down there in the jungle.
Can you do Beggar Man for us?
It's not really humming, though, is it? Is it?
Well, it is when I do it properly. It
stinks.
And that's what all the ladies say.
Factoid. There you go, a bit of Harlem pop trotters for you there. Harlem pop, pick poppers trotters. Bit of jazz funk for you. To an album that I played last week that deserves another outing. Amazing album. The Group Modular. Personally, for me, I love stuff like this. Don't know if you do, but I don't care. Group Modular and Time Masters, the new album. Very spiritual. Very dark. Dark. Anyway, I've got a classic coming up now, because obviously we've been down for a while, haven't we, in the...
Oh, got to get up, man, Smoove.
Got to get up. And what better way to get up than with a bit of dub? And a classic dub at that. Finley Quay.
Oh, it's beautiful. The man he made himself.
Bit of a knob.
Bit of a knob, and then he disappeared.
I'm sure he's still around.
Yeah, but still a knob, though.
Working in Prestos.
No, just being a knob. He made enough money just to cock around and be a knob.
I'm sure he's smoked all that money now.
The murdering. Even after all, you're suffering so. You know I love you so. You know I love you so and so. Even after all. I'll let you go on, sir, is the order of the day. And I'll let you believe, sir, is the order in this society. You know I love you so. You know I love you so and so. Even after all. This is my money, y'all. Man just feels satisfied. No competition, no competition at all. I just feel sad to start. Them eyes a gorgeous girl. No demise, a prize. I got to raise it again. Them eyes are gorgeous. I must advance. I don't check for no superficial. It's got to be beneficial. These sonic fruits. These sonic fruits. Sides. These sonic fruits. Got them moving around. All right. Hyperplay. Stepping and rising. Even after all, the murdering that go on. Even after all, oh no, you're suffering so. You know I love you so. You know I love you so and so. Even after all. You just survived, soldier.
And there you go, Finley Quay. Beautiful song, amazing record.
Or as his sort of career went, Finley Clay, because
Finley Quay into the river
because it disappears.
Al Green.
Can we have a little bit of Barry White out of this, killer?
Was definitely coming.
Gotta be more. Better sing a wretched smoker. Practical joker. More. Just super fly. Trying to be high. More. You understand the better man. More. Better demonstrator. Right.
the Reverend Al Green. There's a song he made years ago, and me and Mabs used to hang around together. This kid from Cramlington, very talented guy. And we got absolutely obsessed with this record called...
To the Sky.
But you see, was that good? I forget.
Yeah, it was a classic. It was called Mold Dust.
Beautiful. That's what it was called, Beautiful. And I actually ended up using the song for my wedding dance. There you go, see? Beautiful. Now... Barry White was requested, and Barry White we shall play. And this is the greatest Barry White song, in my opinion, ever made. Now, Jim Sharp's just done the re-edit, and I played it last week. I'm going to play the original for John Turrell and his wife cuddling up together tonight.
Had an argument this morning with Nicola.
This is a good way to make up. Just play this when you get him.
Yeah, yeah.
Wake her up and go, listen to this, man. Listen to what Smoove says. I'm not playing your games.
Normally I just sit in the living room and I watch old Dave Chappelle.
Mother
Charlie
fucker.
Murphy. Charlie Murphy.
Charlie the fucker. Get your feet off my couch.
Get those big black boots off my couch.
Charlie Murphy, motherfucker. I play basketball with Prince.
Playing
I mean, these songs massively influenced me when I was a kid because me auntie had the albums and used to play them when I was 12. Every time I went down to Bedford, I was like, wow, what is this?
But the groove, though, man.
The production.
The production, the groove. The songwriting, though. You know, like, everything about it. Everyone just, you know, like, I'm not saying everyone, and what I'm saying is, people flip Barry White off like he's some kind of, you know,
cliche,
like,
yeah.
Cliche, sexy, you know, like, guy. Yeah, I do, with Giorgio Estrados, or whatever the fuck he was called. You know, like, with his massive fucking daft cape on and all that, and the rose in his mouth. But Barry White isn't on that scale. What he is one of the greatest songwriters of all time. And, you know, I'm kind of frigid, to be honest. But when I hear Barry, I want to nip back home and do some business. You know what I'm saying? If there's anyone frigid in my relationship, it's me.
Dibby dibby DJ.
Your game, babe. Just you and me.
I've told you this before and we'll tell you again, right? Barry White was getting interviewed once and the guy said to him, so what's the most unusual place that you ever made love? And he goes, well, you know, I was just travelling down the motorway with my lady in my car and I just pulled over in the hard way shoulder right there. Right there, I did it right there. I made love.
To be honest, he couldn't. What was he driving? A monster truck.
Oh, yeah, yeah. A hairy truck.
I just pulled over the monster truck and just let the wheels down.
Delivered my goods.
I had the full string orchestra in the back of the monster truck and we just did it.
Steve McQueen. The Stance Brothers, check this out. Queen and the Stance Brothers, unbelievable 7-inch. John, what's in your screaming little box?
Well, to be honest, I think you plug it in first, which might take us a little bit of time.
A little bit of 3 seconds. One, two, three.
A little bit of time. But then, right, on top of everything, Moss is at work, right? And I hear through the grapevine Well, not through the grapevine. They just blatantly said it. That there's going to be a New York and Soul 2. Can you imagine that, man? My favourite album of the whole... You know, I hope it's not shit. That's all I'm saying. But at the same time, they're starting to release things from ages ago again, just to make your mind go. This is why I love Masters at Work.
Making your mind go.
And if you do what you want to do,
is making your mind go.
Something like that, right? But listen, man.
Listen.
I am the road. Bugs in the Attic. You love Bugs in the Attic. I love Bugs in the Attic.
I do love Bugging in the Attic.
Look, I am the road. Check it out, my man.
Can you not find it or something?
No. I just want to have the fun.
I just like having the fun.
Just like having the fun, man.
Oh, try this.
See, it's you again.
It's the new third turntable.
You're a fucking knob at the minute with this. Look, I'll take this with us tonight, and then everything will go back to normal again.
Fundamentally. Fun mentally. Bugs in the Attic! Shut up.
I can see it.
You know the wonderful thing
about your echoing voice. Just tell us it straight, man.
Well, the wonderful thing about music is sometimes you hear a sample that someone's took and then you go, oh, that's great. And then you go, ah, the original. So that happens a lot in your life, right?
Yeah, but then, totally.
Throughout your life, that happens less because obviously you gain more knowledge. You go, yeah, I know that. But it's, and also people don't sample as much anymore, or they chop it up so fine that you can't, it's like one beep, that's yeah. It. I still get them, though, you twats.
No, but at the same time, that beat makes me feel happy, though.
That's lush.
Yeah. It's a bit like Slow Down, isn't it? You know, like where someone on Twitter goes, wow, this is a great track. And then some daft Russian from, you know, like,
you know where like, you're going.
You know, like from Botslavia.
I know what this is.
Well, it's Alexander Mitrovic.
Zappelini,
who, well,
yeah, we all know who it is now. Shut up and stop trying to sue us.
Stop being it.
Anyway, sampling, remember MC Solar? Everyone remembers MC Solar. The most famous French rapper in England, not in France.
To be honest, though, MC Solar, you know, like, he had the most beautiful flow I've ever heard in my life.
Incredible.
Then I went to Paris with, you know, like,
and then you discovered the real French rap.
No, totally not.
I mean, it was is because Giles Peterson signed one French rapper. That's all it was. That's all we heard.
No,
but
totally
French rap was like the biggest thing, bigger than American rap. It was the
biggest. But I was signed to a Parisian label for like a year and a half, and I spent 6 months in Paris listening to other French rappers. And to be honest, the fucking wiped the floor with them.
But then you also heard the gangster French rap, which was awful. God awful.
Horrific.
Just like a lot of rap, like, there's so many different styles. Anyway, MC Solar sampled this next record, and that was my introduction to this guy. And I was like, wow. And then I bought none of his other music.
Are you ready?
the grooviest disco record ever made. And so underrated as well. That's Music.
Like, how isn't that one of the biggest tracks that you walk into a club to? That's what I don't understand.
Well, you know, every time I walk into a bar, this just comes on.
Is that why you feel so confident about yourself?
Just like that. Yeah, I've arrived.
Yeah, yeah. I got my headphones on. I'm listening to this.
Yeah, I've got my Walkman on.
I got my Walkman on, and I'm listening to this.
My Walkman. You know what I used to do? I used to go to nightclub in the Blue Monkey with headphones on, this big, and walk in and dance out of time with the DJ.
And do that to the DJ. It's Smoove. You're a special man.
Oh, you know, very, very special.
No, I'm talking about special needs. You know what I mean? But you're a great guy.
I need special treatment, yes.
Special treatment?
Right, now, we've just been talking about George Benson, because I could never say his name when I was a kid. I can't now, George Benson.
I was listening to an interview today.
Whoa, say that again?
I was listening to an interview today. And, it was with Masters at Work, and they were just saying about, you know, like, how New York and Soul happened, which is, for me, the greatest album of all time. There's nothing fucking touches it. Every single tune is a killer. So Louis Vega turned around, he went, well, we were in a studio and George Benson was there, and we were just like, hi, George, how's things? And at the same time, George was just like, doing warm-ups on his guitar, and he was just playing his guitar and he was just doing his warm-ups, and Louis Vega went, what song are you playing? He went, it's not a song, it's just a warm-up, it's just how I warm my fingers up. And he went, no, I've never heard anything more beautiful than what you're playing on that guitar. I need to make it into a record. And then the whole thing opened up from George Benson. Everyone on that album was introduced from George Benson. Everyone on that fucking whole thing was there because of one tiny little thing where Louis Vega just went, I love what you're playing there. And that's how albums are written. And this is the...
My Porter, la 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 la. No, it's not.
This is what he was playing on his guitar when Louis Vega met him.
You were talking about their new album, right? When's it coming out?
I don't know. Shut up.
Yeah.
Great Britain, George Benson.
Honestly, man. You know, like, I can't... In a way, I'm a bit trepidatious about how much New York and Soul 2 is going to sound.
Well, it can't be as good because the hype was so big on that last one. It can't be as good, it can't.
But if it's them two involved, I'm sure they're going to find the best people that can find...
They will, but that doesn't necessarily mean the best people are the right people.
I just had a phone call from Louis Vega.
Oh, yesterday. Yeah.
He went, John Turrell, we need you on this album.
And you said, nah, I'm too busy.
I went, yeah, man.
I'm too busy knocking walls, dude.
Yeah, man, I've got to put skirting boards, dude, man, you daft bastard.
Anyway, my original question was... So they're making this new album, but the big question is... Ooh.
When's it coming out on vinyl?
You forgot about that little chest nugget.
That's my favourite, that thing. I think out of all the buttons that you've got, it is my favourite, Lee. Just do it again. Just press it again.
When's it coming out on vinyl?
That's the remix. Now we're going to wind things down now because it's daft o'clock. Goodbye, everybody. Thanks very much for tuning in yet again. Another incredible week. It's been very enjoyable, and we'll see you next week. I'm going to finish with 007 and counting. Now, I've got to say a big shout to Tubes, because when me and Tubes met, we had a conversation about John Barry, and it led to this track. This also goes to Benji B, because I know he loves this.
To the Smoove and Turrell Northern Coal Experience.
The greatest show in the world!